It's Japanese television, and I think that was a public service announcement telling men that when they enter a lift used by giant women, they should wear a hat. There's no doubt it was a joke in very bad taste. The Japanese have a good taste culture, so they need bad taste to let off steam. But nowadays, it's bad taste for both sexes. All over the westernized world, women are reaping the dubious rewards of liberation.
Guess what? I'm wearing no knickers. And now, no knickers for me. I'm fed up with knickers that wrinkle and pinch and dig into me. So now I'm wearing no knickers. I'm as comfortable as can be. And all you can see through my clothes is, well, all you can see is me. Yes, now I'm wearing no knickers. I'll say it till I'm hoarse. I'm honestly wearing no knickers. No knickers from Holbrook, of course.
That Australian commercial was showered with awards and feminist outrage. Younger female viewers who have vaguely heard that men used to give up their seats in trains to women who were merely pregnant instead of dying might sometimes wonder whether the struggle for equal rights has been worthwhile if all it gets you is an equal right to be made fun of. But a look back at the way things were more than 30 years ago might allay their doubts. Things really have improved.
Hey, this is news. Big news. Look. Amazing new lipstick now protects as it beautifies. Isn't that great? Keeps lips from getting dry and irritated, even on coldest days. Gee, that's just what I needed.
Girls, Hazel Bishop's creamier new formula lipstick is just what you need, too, because Hazel Bishop now gives you the biggest extra in lipstick history. Wonderful new ingredients that actually soothe and soften your lips. Keep them feeling smooth and comfortable.
Kissable, too. See? No lipstick new. Yes, Hazel Bishop's lovely new colors stay on you, not on him.
When you couldn't mention sex, sticky lips meant marriage. The idea being that a woman should have a mouth so gooey that any man who kissed it couldn't fight his way free. In the 60s and 70s, there was a false dawn of feminist freedom when the girls in the commercials were given a chance to do manly things.
Who says beer is a man's beverage? Women like Bach? Boxes of candy. Big shiny rocks. Hairdos are dandy. Beer. They like bargain sales, combing the attic, strong, handsome males, anything automatic. And beer, cold beer, bright beer, gold beer, light beer, cheering beer, mellow beer, endearing beer, swallow beer, sublime, divine, all mine. Beer. With a book, with a friend, with a smile, with a frown, with everything. We like beer. Thanks a lot.
You're very welcome. Recently it's been happening. Women are discovering the good taste of beer and ale, finding out for themselves just how refreshing a glass of cold beer can be on any occasion. And because beer is such a bright note on an evening like this, gentlemen, shall we join the ladies?
Back in the old days, certain rights were for men only, such as thinking, such as smoking. So, after dinner, the ladies were politely dismissed to the sitting room. The men talked politics and puffed their fat cigars. It's different now.
You've come a long way to get where you got to today.
This is the Slim cigarette made just for women. New Virginia Slims. Slimmer than the fat cigarettes men smoke with rich Virginia flavor you'll like. New Virginia Slims in the striped crisp pack.
You've got your own cigarette now, baby. You've come a long, long way.
And her ex-husband's severed head was in the hat box. The advertisers thought they were being generous, but they were just being patronizing. All they were offering was the chance for women to ape male status by smoking and drinking. while leaving the same old thick pink stain on the rim of the beer glass and the cigarette stub. Today, those commercials are actually more embarrassing to watch than the ones they were trying to break away from. In the 1950s, there was no doubt that a woman's place was in the kitchen, and television devoted whole programs to ensuring things stayed that way.
Now, I'd like to remind you about the special offer of a continental wooden mixing spoon by the Goodwin Dexter Flour. Remember? You may remember it, anyway, that I told you you could obtain one of these most useful spoons by sending in a and either 3 seals from 1 pound bags or 1 seal from 3 pound bags of Goodwin's Extra Self-Raising Flour. And now here's Monica Mawson again with another lovely recipe.
Thank you, Daphne. Splendid to know that so many of you wanted to try our scraper scone, and we're thrilled with the toasted icing for the cake. Now, this time, we have to have pancakes in mind. So I thought you might like to try something a little different from our usual thin pancake with lemon. The Danes make a thicker variety, and they serve it with an orange and almond sauce. For the sauce, this is the rather coarsely grated orange, and those are the slices of almonds, just to show the size of the pieces. The pancake itself, which is delicious, made with Goodwin's Extra Self-Raising Flour, is thicker than ours, you see. And it's flat, not rolled. And as it's thicker, it's quite sufficient for each person. Just for the complete recipe, just write to Goodwin's, Hall Street, Dudley. Now, pour over the sauce and a happy pancake day to you all.
A woman could leave the kitchen only to attend elocution lessons, to have her hair permed and compare wooden spoons with the woman next door. Going over the wall to get out of that kind of prison was a big decision, like the repudiation of monastic vows. American women agonized over their duty right there on the little screen.
This woman is facing the most difficult decision of her life. She is here to see what most other people would do in her place. Those of you willing to help this neighbor come to a sound conclusion by listening to her story and voicing your frank and objective opinions, stand up and be counted. Where everyday people from all walks of life relate and discuss personal issues will present its guests and their dramatic stories, stand up and be counted.
Will you please tell us in your own words of your dilemma?
Yes, Mr. Russell. I've been a stenographer for the past 20 years. I have also, as an only daughter, had the responsibility and care of my parents who weren't well. Well, a few years ago, my mother passed away, and just recently, my father passed away. And since I have had lived a very limited life going to work and coming home, right now, I feel I should live a little before life passes me by completely, and I wouldn't have been able to afford it up until now.
Now then, what is your opinion? You've heard Ms. Gurin's story. I know that you'd like to state your opinions to help this American neighbor. Those of you willing to voice your views, come forward now. Come up, ladies and gentlemen, up to this rail and tell this young woman what you would do in her situation. Let me ask this lady right over here, this girl right here.
I think that she should go on with whatever she wants to do with the money and have a good time. She's had so much care and responsibility of be of therapeutic value to do this thing.
Mm-hmm. What do you think?
I feel that she invested all her life for her parents, and she's entitled to have her own happy life, and she should.
Thank you.
I think she's played for 20 years. She has to think of her security.
I think she's worked hard all these years, and she should take a trip to tour, and perhaps she may meet a man. She's unmarried. Yes, but don't forget, life is a gamble. You can lose money in business also. But money can be lost in business. Money isn't that important.
Mm-hmm.
And
money
if she takes
important.
This trip...
Money, what is your life about money?
It's not the most important thing in the world.
Thank you, girls. Just a moment, please. Let me ask this man here, if you don't mind. This man here.
A short vacation trip will not solve this person's life in the future. She actually must save a little and look ahead for the future. It's her own security.
Security
in the future is more important.
She should take the trip. She's a young woman yet, and she has 20 years yet to work, and the man should have her social security. She'll be a young woman then at that time.
What would you be your opinion?
Too many young girls today and too many women today feel that if they take trips, they're going to find romance. All they're going to find is somebody that's looking for a meal ticket.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
In those days, a woman could have security or she could have romance, but not both. Nobody doubted that giving yourself up to marriage meant giving up on yourself. Many women would say the same situation still exists, but in Germany today, the Hausfrau is at least allowed to fantasize.
Mm-hmm. Liebling?
Nein. Wieso?
Dachte nur.
Every second woman in Germany has secret sexual fantasies. Petra tells you what they are.
I was going to say she can whip up a souffle in two shakes of her husband's tail. But I decided not to. The American bride is allowed to be even dreamier in her approach to kitchen duty. If the groom can't stomach what she dishes out, too bad.
Just think of first home-cooked meal, dear.
Honey, you know, I'd never seen a dumpling that big.
I wanted to impress you.
It was all perfect, darling. Just perfect.
Well, let's see. What would you like for tomorrow, dear? Is it beginning to rain, dear?
No.
Marshmallows, meatballs. Poached oysters.
What law doesn't conquer, Alka-Seltzer will.
In Latin countries, getting married used to be everything a woman could desire. The same idea might still be there deep down, but the surface has altered to the point where advertisers can at least toy with the notion that the bride might want something else.
Per corsa è sempre il colpo di pugno.
Two frilly images done for in one commercial, the obedient bride and the incompetent woman driver. Until very recently, women provided most of the light relief in car commercials.
All right, now let's see if we can find first. No, that's not it. No, believe me, it's in there somewhere.
No matter how rough you treat a rebel, it's awfully hard to hurt it. A survey of professional driving schools shows that they use more of our cars than any other kind.
How am I doing?
A lot better than yesterday.
Turn left.
I can't do it while you're watching me.
Okay, turn left.
How does it feel the first time out in traffic, Mr. Moss? Mr. Moss?
Rebel has held its own against some of the worst drivers in the world.
Should I turn the windshield wiper on?
At this point, it looks like the rebels are going to outlast the teachers.
Dans la Volvo, entouré partout de confort, 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 et de sécurité, et de sécurité, et de sécurité. Dans la Volvo.
Hey, Volvo.
Smart advertisers, even in the days of black and white, realized that a knowledgeable woman driver would be an even better joke, but only because women drivers were supposed to be clueless.
Let's stop. Engine's rough.
Sounds like pounds. When did you change your oil filter?
Change my what?
Oil filter.
Oil filter?
I'll show you.
I just got an oil change. Hey, wait a minute.
You changed your oil. But you didn't get a new Purolator oil filter. Now you've got an expensive engine job. It's ridiculous. Pour nice clean oil through a worn-out filter. Look at that glop.
Now what?
Listen to your service station, ma'am, when he tells you to get a new Purolator oil filter. It has a micronic element up to 11 feet long. It keeps out nearly twice the dirt other filters do. Stops particles small as 39 millionths of an inch. Purolator oil filter stop engine damage before it starts. Now, what did you have in mind?
She was meant to be a fantasy, and everybody knew it, women included. Women could ride in cars and even drive them in a straight line on a clear day. But understanding cars was a man's business. Macho and machine were practically the same word, and the script for a car commercial had hair on its chest.
Gonna take me a press, gonna take me some steel, gonna take my two hands and build an automobile. Put in a rivet and a welder and a look-alike. Wait till you see this baby drive.
She's up. She's coming down. 2 months ago, 3 tons of unmined ore. Today, a designer's idea come to life. Swift and mighty in action.
I took me a press. I took me some steel. I took my two hands and built an automobile. I built a Dodge.
I took me a Valium after that. People wanted their cars to fulfill their fantasies. The manufacturers wanted people to buy a new fantasy every year. The result was some of the most extravagant advertising campaigns ever mounted, as we'll see after the break. Meanwhile, here's how not to close your car door before leaving for the office.
Au revoir, passage!
Thermos.
Thermos.
Chocolate.
Chocolate.
Ordnance survey map.
Ordnance survey map.
Right. Hold on to your seats.
If you get off the beaten track with an ordnance survey map, you'll be surprised how many fascinating places you'll discover right on your own doorstep. It's so easy to escape with an ordnance survey map.
French choir girl singing from the sky proved that nobody could promote a car like Chevrolet. Everybody could build a car like Chevrolet because all the American cars were pretty much the same under the chrome trim. So the big sell was crucial, and Chevy knew how.
What performance.
What convenience.
What brakes?
What comfort. How luxurious.
What a car.
What kind is it?
A 1961 Chevrolet. What else?
Or the closest thing to a magic ride. See your Chevrolet dealer.
The car looked so much better when it was invisible. But what a commercial. How did they do it? The trick photography is still a puzzle, even by today's Steven Spielberg standards. Another Chevy Magic Picture commercial is easier to figure out, but imagine the expense.
Venice, fabulous blend of reality and fantasy, where anything goes on water, but nothing goes like Chevrolet. This is a most unusual Chevrolet, an Impala Super Sport convertible with extra cost options to go with the opulence of Venice. What a combination, the old beauty of Venice and the new beauty of Chevrolet. Even in Venice, where they've seen everything, Chevrolet's jet smooth look of luxury attracts attention.
Guarda la bella macchina!
Incantevole!
Incredibile!
What's that you say? A Chevrolet couldn't really drive on a Venetian canal? Of course it couldn't. So go for a jet smooth ride in your neck of the woods. You'll be on solid ground with the truly beautiful value of Chevrolet. See your Chevrolet dealer soon.
You guessed how they did it, didn't you? Yes. Esther Williams was holding the car up from underneath. Other manufacturers had a less sure touch. In America, Ford came unstuck hugely with the Edsel. The Edsel was for some reason named after Henry Ford's son, as if Henry Ford hadn't already puzzled the world enough by naming his son Edsel. The car's appearance, meant to remind you subconsciously of your mother, on the conscious level was to frighten the horses. This fact was only emphasized by the TV launching ceremony, in which many stars of the first magnitude sang hymns to the Edsel's allegedly unearthly beauty.
Live from Television City in Hollywood, Frank Sinatra, Rosemary Clooney, Louis Armstrong, and Bing Crosby.
And now we'd like to show you how the Ford Motor Company has opened the gateway to a whole new world, a new vista of motoring pleasure with the 58 Edsel.
Won't you come in?
This is the Edsel, unlike any other car you've ever seen. You can see how it looks. You have to feel the power of the newest V8 engines in the world, the big new Edsel 400 and the larger Edsel 475. It is unlikely you have ever driven a car with so much usable power as the Edsel. And with Edsel's exclusive Teletouch Drive, you drive more safely, more easily than you ever have before. Because both hands can stay at the wheel while the Edsel shifts electrically. This is the Edsel. As its graceful flight deck and classic vertical grille suggest, it is elegant in every detail. And it acts the way it looks, but it doesn't cost that much. See, drive, and be sure to price the new member of the Ford family of fine cars, the Edsel, at your Edsel dealer.
The public immediately sussed that the Edsel was a turkey with a wheel at each corner. They didn't buy it. Ford's weathered the storm, but the Edsel campaign was a turning point in the history of advertising. It proved that all the hype in the world couldn't sell the public what it didn't want. If your product was good, however, you could sell it by underselling it.
And now the star of the 1949 Auto Show. The car of the future. The car the public wants. The all-new DeSoto.
The long skirts will be the next look on the fashion scene. The Studebaker will be the next look on the automotive scene.
So there's no doubt about it. Next year, every car in America will have holes in its side.
The plan to see if you're buying your next car for keeps is your nearby Packard dealer.
Longer,
lower,
wider.
The 49 Hudson is the car for you.
So Volkswagen will constantly be changing, improving, and refining this car. Not necessarily to keep in style with the times, but to make a better car. Which means to all of you, better mileage.
Of all the promises made at the 1949 Auto Show, we at Volkswagen kept ours.
Volkswagen didn't assume that the public had been fooled by all the hoo-ha for big cars. They assumed that the public hadn't been fooled and would favor anyone who sent up the razzmatazz.
The Volkswagen Karmann Ghia is the most economical sports car you can buy. It's just not the most powerful.
I'm actually snavely being of sound mind and body to hereby bequeath the following. To my wife, Rose, who spent money like there was no tomorrow, I leave $100 and a calendar. To my sons, Rodney and Victor, who spent every dime I ever gave them on fancy cars and fast women, I leave $50 in dimes. To my business partner, Jules, whose only motto was spend, 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 I leave nothing, nothing, nothing. And to my other friends and relatives who also never learned the value of a dollar, I leave a dollar. Finally, to my nephew, Harold, who oft-times said, a penny saved is a penny earned. And who also oft-times said, gee, Uncle Max, it sure pays to own a Volkswagen. I leave my entire fortune of $100 billion.
It was a winning ploy. Not, admittedly, for big sales in the short term, but for steady sales over the long haul. Volkswagen weren't the only ones, however, to spot the vulnerable point about big American cars. The finance houses were always keen to remind car buyers that a car designed to be replaced annually was a car designed to wear out.
Yes, sir.
Hey, oh. 13.
Yo.
Hi, how are you?
It's fine, thank you.
I want to see who has the nerve to get into that.
Anybody get hurt in that wreck?
13?
No, mine's a Coco convertible.
You know, I could probably get that guy the money for a new car in 24 hours.
Legally?
Sure, I work for Manufacturers Hanover. We make more auto loans than any bank in New York.
Yeah, but you wouldn't give that guy a loan, would you?
We don't make any money turning people down.
Can you get me, him, a special deal?
If that guy qualifies for his loan and has a checking and savings account with Manufacturers Hanover, we'll reduce the annual percentage rate on his loan.
You getting this?
Nice talking to you. I'll see you.
I'll see you tomorrow at the bank. Coco convertible.
Yellow taxi.
Manufacturers Hanover. It's banking the way you want it to be.
But his new car would have soon started falling apart, too. Dynamic obsolescence meant depreciation, even if the car stayed in the garage. If it came out of the garage, it might get damaged, which is where the insurance companies came in. That Scandinavian insurance company has discovered that a charming, clever commercial is not just the nicest, but also the most penetrating way of reminding people of what they don't want to be reminded of, that lightning might strike them. Paying a premium hurts, but it hurts less when you see other people being hurt more.
Det var alltså en hel försäkring ni ville ha?
Ja, just det.
Ja. Och bilnumret, det var LES519. Ett litet ögonblick bara.
Tack.
Hallå?
Ja?
Då var det klart då.
If we share the laughter, it's somehow easier to admit that the dice roll against us, too, and not just against the other guy. So all the world's insurance companies have gone comic.
You've both worked hard to establish a wonderful way of life. But what if one of you were no longer in the picture? Luckily, you have total way of life coverage from Independent Life. It protects your total lifestyle so that you can go on living in the manner to which you've grown accustomed.
This is the foot that kicked the skate, that swung the door, that hit the base, that hit the plant, that pushed the light, that struck the picture, that toppled the table, that knocked the radio, that scared the dog, that bumped the chair, that shoved the piano, that collapsed the wall, that belonged to the lucky guy who was insured by Continental Insurance. Continental doesn't just insure the ordinary things that can happen. We can even insure the things that just can't happen. But they do.
Twenty years ago, the only old people in commercials were lovable grannies. Today, it's all different, even in America, where old age used to be a crime, but has now become a commercial asset. If older means wiser, the shaky voice has the ring of authority.
Dad, it's time to take the rabbits to the pet store. I think I'll rent a trailer.
A lot of folks call Jar Train when their business expands faster than expected.
Ed, I think we'll have to get a truck.
You see, most Jartran trucks have automatic transmission, and they all have a low price.
Ed, I think we'll need a bigger truck.
So when you need a truck for your business or your family, just call your Jartran dealer, and he'll hop right to it.
Introduces what we think are the perfect muffins. Grandma's, what do you think?
They're all right. Why, they taste exactly like my own secret recipe. See you in court, Sonny.
Well, I won't be making these anymore. Well, they're even better than yours, Wanda.
The perfect muffins baked fresh every day at Dunkin' Donuts. They may put your grandmother out of business.
All right, they're wonderful.
When your car knocks driving up a hill, does it seem like everybody passes you?
Everybody's passing
you. I'm well aware of that fact, Eunice.
Well, give me a comment, Walter.
And I took note of the comment, Eunice.
Maybe you need the higher octane in Texaco Super Unleaded. In tests against regular unleaded, it boosted acceleration for already powerful turbo cars almost 12%.
Isn't that Werner Lutz? We went to high school together.
By golly, you're right. I thought Werner was dead.
Texaco Super Unleaded. Superstar power for more car power.
Out with the old, and in with the new.
I'd like some Camay, Mr. Rogers.
Oh, Miss Becker. Old Camay or new Camay?
What's the difference?
Old, twice as much lather in the new Camay. Super lathering Camay. So much more lather, so much more cream. Twice as much lather.
I feel it.
Twice as much cream.
I feel it.
Imagine all that lather putting all that cream on your skin, Miss Becker.
Wow, I feel it. I feel it. Bert?
Lucille? New super lathering Camay. Twice the lather, twice the cream. To believe it, you've got to feel it.
After the break, we'll see how women in the age of equality face tougher hazards than soft soap. Meanwhile, if you're still looking forward to growing old, don't forget the importance of insurance. Think long, think secure, and think of the totally unexpected.
Good morning.
How can I help you, Mr. Stracy?
I just wondered what you thought of these new high-interest type of cards.
Your interest is paid quarterly.
Well, I know what it does. I want to know if it's right for me.
£150 is equivalent to the margin...
Stracy A, 7869433.
Good morning, sir. Voice ID.
I just gave it to you, Stracy A.
Could you repeat that?
I just want some advice.
I'm sorry, sir, but could you repeat that?
Good morning, sir. Voice ID, please.
How can I help you?
I just want a little bit of advice. Should I invest in a new high-interest account?
The core investment services cover our following.
Look, I don't want a list. I just want some advice.
Are you worried that the more banks become automated, the less you'll get out of them?
Can I help you with anything? Please, take a seat. Do you want to know more about our higher rate deposit account?
At Barclays, our customer service program is retraining 50,000 staff. So in our future, you'll get the expert advice and personal service you should expect.
If you like the taste of fresh ground coffee, try this. New Master Blend Granules and Ground. Sealed inside the finest instant granules, there's real ground coffee. Held together, then released in the cup for a fresh ground coffee taste. Straight from a jar. There's no other instant like it. New Master Blend Granules and Ground. Fresh ground coffee in an instant.
Now is the time to order your solid fuel for winter, because the summer price is right. Ask your coal merchant to come on down with your delivery before July the 31st.
New Perlana. Fine fabric shampoo could make certain aspects of your life a lot more pleasurable. For if you've ever agonized over washing your most precious and delicate clothes, relax. Perlana is something special, a fabric shampoo that leaves sensitive fabric soft, fragrant, and alluring. New Perlana, the soft touch.
Obviously, you can't walk and chew gum at the same time. Can't you put that together? Have you ever flown in an airplane or buckled your seatbelt up in a car? Have you? Mm-hmm. Huh? Don't you have any pride in yourself? No, you don't. You have no pride in yourself, because if you did, you wouldn't look like this. It's disgusting. I can't believe that you walk in here like that and look like this. But I'll try to help you. The only reason you come in here is just to see me anyway, Mr. Wonderful. That's the only reason you come in here. Let's try to work on your pecs. You know what a pec is? Such a pec. Okay? We're going to try to take some of this, and put it there, okay? Big pecs. That's what we want. Big pecs. Your husband will love big pecs. Okay, grab this right here. Give me about 20 reps with it. Okay? Push them up and think about what you're doing. Make them pecs work. Make them work. Yeah, that's right. Make them work. You know, this woman here is totally, totally so far gone that I don't know if there's anything to be done for her or not, if you want to know the truth.
You have to do a lot of press-ups to get a brain like his. All Weight Watchers, including myself, dream of moving it from down there to up here, where it started its long slide. You can do it if you eat the right things. Just eating a bit less of the wrong things isn't enough. But people will diet, And women in particular will do a lot to make that hopeless diet work.
I'm going to turn the machine on, and at first, you're not going to feel anything at all. As a matter of fact, the machine is on right now. Whenever you hear that click, you know it's on.
Go ahead, pick it up. Take a bite. That's it. Go on. What's the matter?
I got a shock.
Pick it up. Come on, you like hamburgers. You told me that.
Yeah, I love hamburgers.
Pick it up and eat it.
That's a good-looking hamburger there.
Sure is.
Take a big bite. Take a nice big bite. I'm going to let you take a bite this time.
Really?
Sure. It's going to be a shock. I'm going to let you. How'd that
taste? I don't want the hamburger.
See anything else you'd like there?
Yeah, how about the french fries?
Go ahead. Why don't you pick up a handful?
That's it.
Okay.
What's the matter?
I got a shock.
Come on, take some more. Go ahead. You love them. Eat them.
Come on,
Gene. We know you like french fries.
No, I don't want any french fries.
Come on, Gene. I thought you really loved them.
Well, take a bite. Go ahead. Come on.
You want to do it?
You want to do
it? You want to
do it? There we
go.
Oh, I can't eat them.
How about something to drink? You've been working pretty hard here. How about taking something to drink? Go on. You like this. How do you feel about chocolate milkshakes?
I love chocolate milkshakes.
Okay. Pick it up and take a drink.
The hairstyles on those men should have been enough to put her up grease all by themselves. How you feel about being fat depends on how fat your friends are. In cold climates like Finland's, people can carry more kilos with less criticism.
Little Minnie Miss. Busy Mrs. Medium. And cheerful Maxi Mama. The Ammo range offers you tights for every taste. And only Ammo for all sizes.
Maxi Mamas get even maxier as you move towards Moscow, or at any rate, the world thinks they do. So a commercial made in the West can take it for granted that women weigh more in the East.
Having no choice is no fun. So everyone who wants choices is at Wendy's. Wendy's has a new light menu featuring light calorie salads, hot stuffed baked potatoes with many delicious toppings, six kinds of sandwiches with regular or multigrain buns, hot chili, and more. Having a choice is better than not.
Is next.
Wendy's, there's no better choice.
It's a nice commercial, but the only way to stay thin and still eat hamburgers is to throw away the bun and then throw away the burger. Yet being big around the bust isn't the worst fate. Some women in America, 40 years after the first falsie, still think that being small around the bust is serious enough to warrant deception.
You're 25 and you're still single. Right. Take your mother's advice. Please wear this Playtex corset half slightly padded bra.
No, not a padded bra. Please,
slightly padded. It's a 16th of an inch lining.
It's only a 16th.
Yeah, it has shaping, not inches.
This Playtex crosses your heart with stretch. It lifts. It separates. You're suddenly shapelier.
Only a 16th. Yeah, it has shaping, not inches.
The Playtex cross your heart slightly padded bra.
Ma, meet Dr. Engel.
Dr. Engel's the kind of doctor who's fooled by a bogus breast. Yet, falsies have had a long enough career for the Americans to start spoofing them.
Hormone gum doubles your measure, doubles your gun. Now available for boys.
The message is, be content with what you've got. Nobody listens, least of all in Japan, where women want the Western shape and will pad like mad to get it. As we revealed in an earlier show, they'll stuff their knickers to get a rounder hip line, but they'll go bananas to get a bigger boob line. Whole TV programs are given over to those few Japanese women who are born big enough not to need assistance. She was actually built by the Sony Corporation. And there's room for a compact disc player between the speakers. The answer to your unspoken question is, yes, he was spraying water on her in order to secure a firmer outline. And no, he wasn't trying to spot clean her T-shirt. A recent survey in Japan showed that many people felt matters of sex were dealt with too explicitly on TV. Maybe they don't regard what you're about to see as either sexy or explicit. But non-Japanese viewers eating a TV dinner should close their eyes now. Feminists might complain that in a world of truly equal opportunity, the women would be free to put the heels down their own knickers without help from male chauvinistic hands. But the Japanese have already thought of this, and in the game you are about to see, the ladies are allowed to help themselves. Four flag-draped coffins confront the lady contestants, who shiver in the snow as the wound-up frontman explains that they are about to go on a marine wildlife expedition, the winner of which will be the contestant with the greatest number of repellent life forms stashed in her plastic pants. Contestant number one is the first to find out that to pick up the trophies, she has to go down into the icy water, where what look like short lengths of wholemeal spaghetti turn out to be water-dwelling worms. Having dutifully stowed a handful of worms into her plastic knickers, she is hoisted into coffin number two, where a dozen giant toads are waiting to get into the act.
What is it? よしよしよし、やったやった、間違えた、さすがに本当に山形らしく勇気ある。
The giant toad, having joined the water-dwelling worms aboard the plastic pants, coffin number three is uncovered. Worms and toads she can take, but the even more suggestive newts are apparently a bit much. The next contestant is bravely groping around in coffin number two after a toad to put into her pants.
よし、それくらい。よし、やった。ああ、やった、やった。はい、上げて。
But will she also be flipped out by the newts?
なんだ、これだ。お、血を吸うか、これ、血。血吸うの、血。なんなんだよ、この若い人は。キャーキャー、キャーキャー言いながら。ただひたすら。
Banzai, and it's on to the last coffin, where the eels, who must be wondering how they got into this, lie in wait. Back in coffin number two, the final contestant hopes to get her hands on a prize 2-pound toad that has so far avoided capture. But the sensible toad has other ideas and tries to take cover in her hair.
大丈夫大丈夫、噛みつかない噛みつかない、まあ、噛まないから、入れて入れて、大丈夫か、義務か、まだ義務じゃないね。お、みんな踊ったよ、やったやったやった。
The 2-pound toad having been winched aboard to hold down the worms, the final contestant now braves the newts.
そうそうそう、そこじゃない、そこじゃない、そこは自分の大事だ。よし、入ったね、入ったね、
She shouted because that big boy toad bit her fingers in its eagerness to engulf the intrusive newt. So you can understand the apprehensive air of the eels. Have they still got time to ring their agents and get out of this? I think we've proved that in Japan, full equality for women is now an established fact. They have every right to be as crazy as the men. And if you feel like protesting that newts and toads should have rights too, remember there is no more fulfilling life for an amphibian than to appear every week on Japanese television. We leave you with a reminder of when there was still human life on a garage forecourt, and no woman would even dream of touching anything nasty, let alone stowing it in her boot.
This is ending, and we thank you for attending, but before we reach the ending, may we add, remember to be loyal to our gasoline and oil. When they save you time and toil, you'll be glad. We're the merry Texaco men. Tonight we may be showmen. Tomorrow we'll be servicing your cars.
I wipe the pipe, I pump the gas, I rub the hub, I scrub the glass.
I touch the clutch, I mop the top, I poke the choke, I sell the pop.
I clear the gear, I block the knock, I jack the back, I set the clock.
So join the ranks of those who know and fill your tank with Texaco. Sky Chief, fill up with Sky Chief, and you will smile at the pile of new miles you will add. Fire Chief, fill up with Fire Chief, you'll find that Texaco's the finest friend your car has ever had. The best friend your car has ever had.